How's it going, guys? This is the Core 3 from fightinggamesonline.info, and I'm back with another emulator tutorial. For this time is for the PSX2, which is basically the PS2 emulator, and I wanted to go over this one. I've been wanting to go over this one for a while, just haven't had the chance to get it to work, you know, and just test it out. But I think for the most part, you know, I don't think it's going to get change any, so I decided I'll go ahead and do the tutorial. Mainly, you know, why I would go over this one is because, you know, it's an alternative for certain games when it comes to playing them all, you know, fighting games online. And of course, there's a certain, you know, titles that they have that were not available on, like, the Dreamcast or, you know, the GameCube emulators. So of course, you know, definitely something to consider when you want to get online and play somebody. You know, this you know, from what I've heard, this seems to be the more preferred emulator when it comes to playing Capcom versus SNK2. So that's, you know, mainly one of the reasons that I want to go over this emulator today. So let's go ahead and get started. So hopefully you are on the page. If not, you can look below the description of the video and you'll find the link to come here. Hopefully you can just follow along with us so you won't get lost during the setup. Alright, so first thing of course we'll do is we'll download the emulator, and of course all you have to do is hit download. I've already downloaded it, so you know, I'm just gonna kind of skip that part and, you know, go straight to putting it on the desktop as I usually do. Yep. So as usually, I will unpack it on the desktop. That's usually the easiest place to find it. So that's what I will do. I'm going to go ahead and name it PSX2. You do have to make a folder for it, otherwise it will get spread all over the place, and you don't want that. Alright, so let's come out of this. Alright, and let's find the PS2 folder, which is right here. Alright, so just a few things that I want to kind of go over, of course, before we jump into any, you know, into, you know, running the game. You're of course going to need to get the BIOS. The BIOS is like the most important thing. You know, I can't provide the BIOS, you know, for various reasons. For both players, you will have to have the same BIOS. That's the most important thing, is that both players have the same BIOS. Otherwise, the game's probably not going to run properly when you guys connect to each other. So that's just one thing that I want to note. Okay, so I think we're ready to go ahead and go into the emulator itself. So let's go ahead and click the PSX2.exe and let's run it. And of course, the first thing you want to do is start to set up your emulator. There's one option that of course we're going to have to make sure that it's off, and that's in the game fixes. Usually this right here is checked. You want to uncheck skip MPEG hack. You may even want to go ahead and just take this off in general, just to be on, you know, on the safe side. Yeah, that's the only thing that you will not need. In most cases, when it comes to speed hacks, if, you know, for any reason you need to go ahead and enable this. Most times, I believe it's the spin detection, enable this one, and then the flag hack. I believe those are the only ones that they usually turn on for speed hacks. But you're probably not going to need to. I mean, this is basically, you know, if you cannot get your game to run at 60 frames per second, this is kind of what you use to increase the speed, and that normally shouldn't affect you know, the online gameplay, but I definitely can't be sure about that. But that's just in case, like I said, your game is not running at 60 frames per second. Okay. As usual, you know, you can pretty much, I think it's, you know, fair to say that you can change mostly everything, you know, as far as like resolutions. You can do your own, you know, 6x9, you know, 4:3, whatever is most suited for you, you know, you can go ahead and change that. Okay, so this should be okay. So I hit apply and go to. All right, the next thing that you want to do is make sure that your controller, of course, is all set up. So you just hit controller's pad and go to plugin settings. All right. And then, of course, we come over here to pad one. And it's just as simple as basically taking, you know, coming over here and basically correlating the button to your control pad. Okay. So, you know, you would just hit square and then the button. And then, of course, you'll see it come up here. Let me clear this. Okay. So, you know, just hit square there, triangle, circle. And, of course, you continuously do this until you have all the buttons set up. Oh yes, also before I forget, there's also, you can also set up your video settings as well. You know, you could go on the plugin. Of course, this might have to, actually, right, this might have to get reset after you do this. So just kind of have that in mind. But I'm just gonna look at my video driver, and you'll notice that right now it's rendering on Direct 3D9. There is an option to do Direct 11. I don't know how, you know, how better it will make it, but you know, it should not affect the settings that you have as far as playing online. I don't believe so. I think like one of the things that, you know, of course you can use if you have like issues. You might notice that the video kind of looks a little jumpy. So you can use one of these filters to stop that from happening. I think that's about it for just video settings, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and reset this and then I'll come back. All right, so I have everything that I wanted to set up. Should be all ready to go. So let me come out of here. And the next thing that you're gonna do is, of course, you have to run the game. So basically, I set it up on a different drive, okay? For most of you, you know, if you wanna go ahead, make it easy on yourself, you know, what you can do is, let me just go back to the folder here. Just give me 1 second. Is you can create a ROM folder within here. You know, just simply just do a new folder, put a ROM folder. Of course, this is where you're going to put your games in. You know, most of them are going to be ISO. You know, from what I, you don't know, it's mainly ISO. Okay, so just wanted to add that. But for me in particular, I'm going to go to another place because I put mines in a different place. So just give me a second while I do that. So you're going to go to ISO selector, you're going to hit browse, and of course let me go find where I put mine. I think I put mine in right ROMs, and I got mine in right here, and it is, we're going to try, of course, Capcom versus SNK. That's going to be our example here. And of course, the first thing that you want to do is just make sure that it is running before you do anything else. I don't really know the difference between booting up full or booting up fast. I don't know how much of a difference that makes. We're going to go ahead and just go with the fast boot up just to make sure that everything is running smoothly. Oh yes, before you do that, of course, you want to make sure that you have selected your BIOS. Otherwise, of course, the game won't run. Okay, so of course you have your video, you know, configured the way you like it. You have your controller configured the way you like it. And you also have made sure that the game is running at the proper speed. Once you've done all that, we are ready to go ahead and do the Netplay. So let's go ahead and go to the boot Netplay. And we're going to go ahead and run this both ways, you know, with hosting and connecting. Now, of course, this runs on a P2P. So in order to play with somebody else, you're going to have to give them your IP address, or they're going to have to give you their IP address. Okay. The next thing, of course, that's important to note is that you have a default port of 7500. Now here, I've added my port that I've already opened through another game, which is Yatagarasu. I did a tutorial on that if you want to check that out. If you don't know about opening ports, definitely check that out. Okay, so let's go ahead and press OK. Of course, the person who is connecting to you should already be set up to connect. So just hit OK. Okay, so some reason I gotta do a restart. Hold on 1 minute. Okay, so I forgot one thing, of course. Anytime you finish up a session, when you connect this to somebody, most times they're gonna want you to restart again. So make sure that once you're done with the session, and if you wanna go back and do another session, that you restart, okay? Anytime that you're ready to reconnect. All right. I'm going to go ahead and hit OK. One thing before I start is that if you hit OK, you might just get a notification asking you to allow access. Make sure that you hit OK, otherwise you won't be able to connect. All right, so let's go ahead and try this. Okay, so I think the process may be that you have to host before you actually connect to somebody. I'm not sure if that's correct, but I think you might want to wait a minute and let the host connect first, okay? So let's go ahead and run this game, and hopefully it will work this time. Alright, and we have a connection. Alright, and of course you know that because they're basically giving you the name right here, which is what I chose as the username on the second computer. And for the most part, you're going to want to go ahead and at least put the input delay up to about 5, maybe, to be on the safe side. Of course, this all depends on the type of connection, you know, of the person that you're connecting to. You know, normally you do not want to connect to anybody with, you know, over 150 when it comes to input delay, especially. So, you know, just something to consider before you get started. Okay, so after that, the only thing you have to do, of course, is press OK. And of course, the other person has to press OK on their end. And then you're all set to go. And then, of course, the game should start running. So of course, you basically just be running it like a regular, you know, one versus one player match. And that's pretty much all there is to it. So let's go ahead and try it the reverse way. And, you know, I'll show you how you set it up on the other end. Okay, so this time around, we'll be connecting to the person. So like before, it's pretty much the same setup. The only difference is, of course, now that you have a what you call the local port, and you have the host port, which is going to be the same. Okay, so let me go ahead and just put this in. And of course, you have the address, of course, which should be your IP address, the person that you're playing against. should be giving you their IP address, and then of course you would put that in. So here is mine. I'm gonna put my address in. Oops. 680. All right. And then all I have to do is hit OK, and I should be able to connect. Let's see if it happens. Alright, so we have connection. Of course, as usual, I will hook up the input delay. And then, of course, I just have to say, and of course, you'll notice over here that, you know, the input delay has been changed to 4. And then you just hit OK. And as usual, everything should run like it did before. Okay. So that's all there is to it. Of course, other things, of course, if you run into any issue, you might run into some issues. Unfortunately, there may be some desyncs. It just depends on, I guess, you know, how you set it up and what the connections are. There are a lot of troubleshoots out there. We've added a Discord community. So hopefully, you know, people can help you if there are any issues with trying to get connected. Okay. So that's kind of it for the tutorial. Hopefully you'll be able to get online and play. All right. So enjoy it and take it easy.